All right, I just dragged it down this steep sand bank here, and oh boy, oh Jesus, freaking kidding me? All right, this ought to be fun. Let's do it like that. There we go. That wasn't bad. Because it ain't gonna be easy. Nothing's easy, right? All right, now we're slopping the mud. The river. All right, well, that's long, long road bridge, and here I am. Getting started on the Little Muskegon. It's challenging already. A lot of obstacles. Hung up on a tree. Not really. I just kind of let it stop there so I could get the GoPro going. This ought to be cool. Just hope there ain't a million trees down, and hit a tree and it'll knock the GoPro off my head. Might find a hole deep enough for swimming. Got some high sand banks. I remember a few spots in the, I did this river, oh, I don't know, man, a couple times. Two, three, maybe more. Oh, man, it's just nice to get out of the car. I'm glad I got some cloud cover here, too. That's kind of cool. Nice sandbank. Lot of obstacles. Uh-oh. This one don't look good. Let's see what we gotta do here. Oh, I might be able to. I already scared up a little baby deer. Uh-oh, I got to duck low. Made it. Oh, this is a good one. Really? Ah, right through the notch. Oh boy. Get this on camera, huh? Freaking kidding me. Now all I gotta do is get back in, right? Without tipping. Oh shit. Oh shit, dog. Whew. Okay. Obstacle one. Beaten. Man, I just missed a giant, big-ass turkey. Flew from one side to the other. And then a heron. Took off, too. Tell you, if this was fast water, like high, it would be dangerous, because you got to make a lot of choices real quick, and it's slow now, so you have time, but man, look at this. You come around some of these bends and you're like, oh no, there's no way I'm getting through. And then there's one little opening and I'm gonna bottom out. But that's all right. This one does not look good. Whoa. At all. Slow it down a little bit here. Man, if you were going fast through here. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. Point upstream. Get into this eddy here and have another run at it. Wow. Should I go to the left? Yeah. I ain't got no fucking choice but to go to the left. No. Alright, that's one. Holy Christ. Made it. A few tree limbs off, but Jesus. Have a drink of water, look at the clock. Can't let off the paddle for like more than like 10 seconds without getting into some kind of obstacle or a hazard. Uh-oh. I'm a little low. Can I get by? All right. Look at that. Got it. That's nice. I tell you what, I've never seen a more wood-choked river in my life. I've done this 3 or 4 times at least in the past. It was never like this. Not this bad anyway, that I can remember. It's insane, folks.
Should I go over that low tree or try and duck under? Oh man. Over. I don't like the duck deal there. I know this ain't gonna fly, but whatever. It is what it is. Just past Dagget. It's 11:30. I started at 9:30. So that was 2 hours just to get to there. I think that's Dagget. I mean, it's a bridge. So, hang a Ricky, then a Louie. A Louie. Houses now. It's 12:20. Almost 3 hours. Oh, time is it? Well, I went under a another bridge at 12:30. So the first bridge at 11:30, the second bridge at 12:30. Well, it's 1:30. 4 hours. Started at 9:30. Oh boy. I don't know. Rocks. Alright, it's 2 o'clock. Four and a half hours. No more houses.
Well, that was the Little Muskegon. After that last clip, I dumped a kayak, hit a rock. GoPro got wet. I didn't have the waterproof housing on. Didn't think I was going to dump. So I missed coming out to the lake onto Croton Pond and going across the whole lake. It was very, very beautiful. The last hour or so opens up pretty good and boats could get about maybe a half hour upstream by kayak, you know. Small boats, and got to the launch 6.5 hours. I'm gonna do the big Muskegon next time. Out.